Right now in Washington, dueling plans to end the shutdown and avoid default. The Senate's version would fund the government until mid-January and extend the debt limit until February. The House just came out with a slightly different plan. It provides funding until December 15th and cancels health insurance subsidies for Congress, their aides, and the president and his administration. And we've just learned the House is expected to vote tonight. We have a team of reporters working on the shutdown developments right now.
First, though, an Iowa exclusive. KCCI's own Kevin Cooney sat down face-to-face with the president today in Washington. He joins us live from the White House. And, Kevin, you talked to the president specifically about those dueling plans today.
Indeed, we did, Eric and Elizabeth. Good evening from the White House. It didn't take the White House long to react to this initial plan that came from the House of Representatives pretty much as soon as it arrived this morning. And, again, we're talking about that first plan. It was DOA.
We don't need to close the government, and we don't need to default on our debts simply because parties disagree.
Once again, another short-term budget deal was unveiled, and once again, the president put the House conservatives in his sights.
There's a faction there that believes any compromise of any sort is unacceptable, that they've got to get 100% of what they want, or at least a lot of what they want, and they haven't been willing to engage.
And that, says the president, is the difference. The Senate is engaging in bipartisanship, says Mr. Obama. But meanwhile, deadlines loom.
I remain optimistic that this will eventually get resolved. The challenge is, can we get it resolved soon enough? We need to do this soon, and we should stop with the posturing and the political face-saving, and we should just go ahead and get things done.
But what's to say all this won't happen again if the Senate plan gets through and for 3 months things quiet down?
If we come to the table in a spirit of compromise of the sort that you're now seeing in the Senate, I am confident that we can get a long-term budget deal, and then we can stop governing from crisis to crisis.
But crisis is exactly where the government remains right now until a deal is done. Lesson learned?
Here's the good news, is that if there's a silver lining in this whole thing, which never should have happened in the first place, it's that I suspect Republicans, at least many Republicans in the House and Senate, and certainly Republicans all across the country, now recognize that the way we're going to resolve this is for both sides to engage in some give and take. So I don't think that pursuing a strategy of shutdown is something that they'll be keen to repeat.
So for now, most eyes are on that revised proposal that is going to be voted on, as you just heard, in the House tonight, or at least it's scheduled to be voted on. But there is also some speculation as to whether it could even pass the House, and this all may be a moot question because it's going to be given no chance in the Senate, as far as we can tell right now.
Kevin, you've been to the White House before a time or two to interview presidents. What was the feel around the White House today? Did it feel any different than other times you've been there?
There sure were a lot of comings and goings here. Nancy Pelosi was here earlier. She used terms like sabotage to describe what the House Republicans were coming up with. And I want to make sure I get this right. House Democrats say the House bill is a reckless attempt to torpedo any chance of compromise.
What did he say?
And Kevin, what are we going to be hearing coming up tonight at 6?
Well, speaking of compromise, isn't that convenient? We're going to be talking to the president about just how much of the Affordable Care Act might be on the table if we get a partial budget deal that lasts for a few months to give them time to negotiate a larger budget deal. And in that larger budget negotiation, is Obamacare on the table? And if so, how much? Might be surprised by what the president had to say.
All right, Kevin Cooney at the White House in Washington, thank you very much. KCCI was one of only three stations in the entire country invited by the White House to interview the president today. So why us? Mark Tauschek is live.